What's good with y'all? What's good? What's good? What's good? What's good? We tuning in for another video. Excuse me. Today, trying to get ready for the track. Gonna go on 2 days back to back. Well, I'm ready, but instead of taking meat, basically this one going first. This one going to the test and tune day. Then they having a little event. I'm getting the rim clad, but instead of taking meat, cause I ain't got them hangers welded up, them exhaust hangers, I don't want no further damage happening there. Too expensive, I'm gonna take Dolo. So I'm about to drain the little bit 93 that's left in here. I'm finna drain the 93 out the tank so I can pull some racing gas in there. It's a chance of rain, so I'm just gonna put 1 gallon in it. You know, pull it on trailer and all that, so that way, get to the track, if it do start raining, looking ugly, I won't be sitting with 5-6 gallons of racing gas in a car and just have to ride it out. So that's the plan. So I'm finna drain this joker, man. And then that's all I gotta do with Dolo. Dolo ready, tuned up. We gotta go get some nitrous today. So wife is gone. So right now I'm gonna get that done and I'm gonna try to get these seats out before she get back. Cause then my main task for the day, get the seats switched over in Altran. I'm gonna go ahead and get these seats out of here. And I've been having a lot of people hit on the old seat, so I go ahead and get them out the car, man. They'll be ready, which that it don't take long to take seats out, man. I mean, it's four nuts on each seat, half inch. I think the half inch of 14 or 9/16 one. And then, you know, you got your two big star bolts at the bottom where your back seat just pop up. Then you got your star bolts at the bottom hole, your back pattern, and then they just clip out. So easy. I took plenty of them out. But let me get this gas drained so I can come from out there heat before it get too crazy. And I'm gonna check back in.
All right, check it in, y'all. Got to set up the kitchen. Let's see. Got my AN wrench. Racetronics AN wrench. Ooh. Probably just cut myself. That look blade, boy. I probably got myself then. So good. Let's see. Ooh, that's on burning too. I don't want to get crazy. I might let it slow roll out of there. And finna drain it. So I don't want to go crazy. Ooh, that's on cold. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go get a band-aid too, this joint here. Play about this stuff, boy. Get infected. Let's get cut, man. You go tend to it. Hope we get cuts in shop, man. They don't do nothing. They just keep going. Turn into a bigger problem. That might be all right. So we're going to let that finish draining. We're going to just let it ease out of there like that, man. I ain't got to be on the hill. It'll all come out. So while they're going, we're going to
go ahead and take the seats out, and then we'll just come back, check on this here and there. So let's do that, y'all.
All right, y'all, we're taking in. So look, 13 millimeter. You know what that is, 13. I couldn't remember the standard metric. That's all you need, man. Four nuts. You know, you got studs come up through the floor. That's it, man. They come up out of the, but you got the power. Power makes it a lot faster. So all I'm gonna do is break it loose. I'm gonna break them loose with the hand rest. Then I'm gonna put the power to them. Zip them up out of here.
All right, I got the two fronts out, man. Made quick work of that. I roll a tile out for y'all, and I seen the gimbal. The gimbal just decided to flip. I apologize for that. But let me see. It's a good time to backing this joker, clean this joker out. Carpet actually look pretty good in here, but I'm gonna end up going with some gray. I want some gray carpet, man. But the carpet look pretty good in here. I need to get all the bolts too. You know, a lot of people don't never use all of them, but I do. I would prefer. They easy to get to anyway, but a lot of people end up just doing four bolts, which this pretty much what they had. Cause they don't be wanting to fight with that one. That one right there, D1, they don't be wanting to fight with them. But yeah, there would be a good time to vacuum, but I ain't stressing it, cause I'm gonna have to take the, I'm ultimately gonna have to take the seats out again when I get ready to put the gray carpet in. So it really ain't no sweat on there, but this carpet is in good shape. But the color I'm going with, I don't know. Ooh, this seat dirty. Discount that. I ain't really had this seat like that. It was just sitting up there. When they ain't in there. Yeah, I'm gonna discount that. Good seat. Good cushion, good foam and stuff though. This ain't clean as I like. Said stuff being the shade. Yeah, that joker there dirty. But that can come out, man. I might shampoo that joker. That's, you can get that stuff out. Believe it or not, you can get that out, make that look brand new. I had the seat for sale by itself for $200, but I'm probably just do $150 on the back seat just cause of that. So seat belts. See, there you go. You got two star. You got your two stars. People that ain't never done this, this junk ain't hard. You got your two stars right. They ain't even clipped. Oh, amazing. Man, see, I need the star bolts. I don't have none of them. I don't even know what size it is. I don't like stuff like this, man. I like to do stuff right. That's an old rear view. So that means they're just sitting up there. Let's see. Star. Let's see. That one. Hold it down. Cause it ain't got no seat belt retractor. That's what it is. Go to the seat belt. So I need that. Man, I need seat belts right here in the back. All right. See, I don't like running stuff like this, cause that means I'm gonna have to go do it all over again, extra time that I don't want to do it. Cause it's just a lot easier to work the back seat when you ain't got the front seats in the way. So I'm gonna be doing this over again. Cause we got to have seat belts, man. I'm gonna do all this stuff new. These, I'm gonna do them new, man. You have seat belt rethreaded. So while you do stuff, you discover stuff. That's why you tend to your car. So let's see if I can get that. I know if the guy still got it, I'm gonna grab here. So let me contact him, man, and the guy I bought the seat from, cause he got all this stuff. So I can get that. So I'm gonna contact him. We're gonna get that back seat out. We're still gonna get the new stuff in for now to get it out the car. And I'm gonna check back in. All right, out with the old. Got the old out, got it all stripped. I talked to the guy I purchased the seats from. He got the seat belts. So I'm gonna end up just getting all of them. Get these two, cause he's still perfect. He said he didn't want to separate them. I respect that. So he want to sell them as a set. So we're gonna have two new retractors, new front belts and stuff. So that way, man, it'll all match up. I just changed everything. It ain't gonna hurt nothing. I don't need no side panels. You can see the side panels are great. They in great shape, which I don't like fooling them, honestly, no way. I do not like taking them off. I'll tell you no lie. But everything get cool back there in the back. So I'm gonna go and pop this seat in, put that one seat belt and retract on over there on the passenger side for right now. And Monday, I'll be able to get up there with him and pick up that stuff, cause I bought an AC control from him anyway. I gotta pick up, and then I can get all the bolts and all that stuff. And really could, I might just wait since I'm going up there, cause I sent Flex. My boy Flex went and got my seats for me last time, cause I couldn't make it. So I might just end up taking those bolts and screws and all that back, cause I go up there, I can get everything he had to take out. We know it'll be right. So little by little, man, coming together. I'm gonna order some carpet, a new dash cover, and the interior be pretty much done. I'm gonna get a console too, a gray one. And interior be pretty much done, man. Headliner, but I'm gonna get that done. Get a dome light too. I'm gonna get it done when I get my boy Alex to do the music, cause he know I do headliners. He can do it all at one time. So y'all see the before, you're gonna see the after I get this stuff back in. So look, I had slipped the back seat in, then it hit me. I said, okay, reason the back seat, the old back seat, I got the back end, but I ain't tripping, cause I'm gonna have to do this all over when I get the new stuff to put the seat belts in, which ain't no pressure. But the reason it won't clip, cause you see the carpet, when you lay the carpet in, you need to cut out your access holes right there. Cause you have to push it hard. You have to push on the front. You moving in there and it clips in there. So you have to push on the front of this cushion real hard and it just goes boop, pop in there, and then your seat secure. That's what hold it in. So need to cut out access holes for this car. They're gonna be under the seat. So I'm gonna go around it with a razor. I'm gonna start my slit with the razor and go in there with the utility scissors. They're sharp as all outdoor. And then we're gonna clip it in there pretty smooth. So I just figured I'd show people that. Don't try to push it through your carpet, cause it ain't gonna clip. Or you're gonna bend it, or you're gonna mess on up. So when you put your new carpet in, cut your access holes out right there. One right there and one on the other side. And your seat clip ain't easy. So still want to point that out to you, man, for people that don't know, first time doing it, then you're trying to do your stuff yourself, cut your holes out right there. For this right here. That's what you need. Just a little spot. All right, so I got the access holes cut. So let me show y'all what I'm saying so y'all can see what it look like. That's what I mean. It ain't gotta be perfect. It's gonna be hid. You just don't wanna get into where it start going downhill. Then you will see it. So you just want some access so you can clip the seat in there, man. You ain't fighting against the carpet. So we pop that back seat in, get the fronts in. It'll be a wrap, man. And then we got to run to A-Rod Performance because I need nitrous refill for Dolo. And I actually have to, I got my in-laws, they headed to Summit, pick up a couple carburetor kits. I got a customer's card that came in today. I need to at least get broke down. I might get it broke down and done today if I finish everything in a timely manner. And what I'm gonna do is add another bottle bracket to the back, so that way I can fit a 15 pound or a 10 pound nitro bottle in Dolo, because that's what I want to take tomorrow. I want to take one 10 pound, one 15 pound. This should be enough for the day. So I want to make a dual purpose, so it's gonna take either or when it comes to the nitro bottle. So that's my last actual task that I'm gonna have to do, is drill some holes and get the appropriate size nut and bolts, so I can bolt the other bracket down in the trunk, and that car be ready to roll, man, for Sunday. Altran ready. I'm just doing it cause I want to get the stuff out the shop, and then a lot of people been hitting on the interior, so you know, that's what it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and probably next time y'all see me turn the camera on, have all the interior in for the sake of time, cause I want to try to go ahead and get over to A-Rod early so I can get back and I ain't scrambling. So let's get that, get it done, man. So I just want to show y'all that, so y'all can get a visual and see what it looked like, what I mean. So let me get this interior back in, then I'm gonna show y'all what we're looking like. All right, I know I said I wasn't gonna take it, man, but I gotta show y'all. It's looking too good. It's looking too good. We look like money. It's amazing what interior and wheels would do for a car, man. When I say this thing looking like money already, hold on, let me throw this away. I told y'all, man, the bill before the bill. I bet people didn't believe me. The bill before the bill, man. I took a break from everything, but I'm hype about this, man. Seeing this come together, it's just a pregame build, getting me ready for the big boy, the T-top. But look at that, man. That's amazing. The difference some nice interior do. Wait until I put the door panels on. The door panels gonna bring it out even more. When you ain't looking here, seeing no metal, the door panels gonna bring it out even more. And when I get that fresh gray carpet, I mean, it look good now, don't get me wrong, it do look good with the black. When I vacuum it out real good, it's gonna look jammed up. But when I put it like it's gonna be the gray, well, I might keep it black. I might keep it black, honestly, but I still replace it, but cause it'll flow. But when I put that dash cover on here, man, it's gonna be on. The headliner don't look that bad, but I'm gonna get it new and crispy, and then put a dome light up there, wire it up so it works, and we're gonna be dead in there, y'all. I told you, the interior ain't gonna take long. Then I'm gonna buy me a console and bolt it down like it's supposed to. Gray console, fresh gray. Cut this slot out nice and neat for this shifter. Man, we finna be in there. So I just had to show y'all, cause when I came out the pedal side and look, I said, good gracious, boy, it already looked better. Especially with the back seat not just flopping around. It's in there secure like it's supposed to be. So let me get the last seat in, man. We'll be done with this one. Okay, so we all done, man. Looking like new money. Look at that. All done, man. I went ahead and vacuumed the flow too over here. I just said, man, I might as well. I went ahead and vacuumed it. We looking like new money, man. Fresh new buckets. Interior nice and crispy. Look at the back seat. Super nice. In there tight like it's supposed to. Ain't got no stuff sagging. Sagging everywhere, man. In there like it's supposed to. Then we can get the deck cut too. Gonna work on that. Door panels next. That's what I'm ready to see. When you put the door panels in there, man, cause it's still like an eyesore when you look in there, cause you can see straight metal. But we get them door panels in there. Oh man, it gonna be in there, man. I was gonna put that one on over there today, but I said, man, I just wait. Cause I gotta go up there and get the new seat belt stuff. So I'm gonna swap the seat belts out. And I'll probably just swap the seat belts out once to get the carpet. I'll just go ahead and get the carpet. Order that, so that way I won't have to take the seats in and out no more. I'll take them out there one last time, lay the new gray carpet in there, put the seat belts in all together, fresh seat belts in the back. I'm gonna get the clip, the covers right here, He might have them too. But put the new seat belts in, then I won't have to take the seats out no more. And I'm missing one. Well, I want it like the factory, man. So technically, it's two to go in the back. So it's missing one, and I'm missing one over there. I only got three, but it's cool for right now. One, two, three. Three over here and one over there. The nut, y'all know they special kind of nuts with a big, huge flat washer made on tool. But I'm gonna pick them up when I go get the rest of the stuff I bought from the guy. So, I'm gonna order the carpet, get that coming ASAP Rocky. The console, I ain't really worried about no pressure on them things is high, but I'm gonna get one. I'm gonna get a console. But that's easy to put in. That don't require no seat removal for all of that. So ain't tripping on that. So carpet next, then dash cover. So I can put the dash cover on there. Then it look like it's a brand new dash in there. I'm gonna fix this stuff on the column. You can buy these, man. I know where to get them from. So I'm gonna fix that. Tighten that up. They need to be tightened up. I'll probably do that today. Yeah, man, we're gonna be in there. So we look like money now, man. That's the old stuff for sale. Said got it out. I'm finna put it up. I'm gonna keep it in here probably seven more days, one more week. After that, I'm putting it up because I've been had a lot of hits on them, but now I got better pictures so I can see what people gonna do. But other than that, I'm gonna put it up in the storage out in the shed. So cause it take up too much space in my shop. I don't like my shop looking cluttered. I do not like the shop starting to look cluttered, man. It's too cluttered for me right now. And it ain't bad, but it's too cluttered for me. But some stuff got to get gone. Like these radios right there, them cuzzos. I need to take them by his house. They've been riding the back of train smoke forever. My Monte Carlo mags, they okay because they going right back on the car after I come back from the track. And then these tires, I don't even know where I'm gonna stack them, man. I need to see them slicks. Them slick going out in the stores too. Oh, they brand new, but they going out in the storage, man. But somebody, hoping somebody buy them soon. But other than that, they going out in the storage. Cause I'm gonna need to put these slicks, these radios in that spot. The door be out of here. It'll be gone soon. Rick gonna get the door. He gonna gut it. He gonna go ahead and gut that door right there. We're gonna take everything out of it. Put everything in here. We don't know if everything in this one bad, but for the sake of not doing it twice, we're gonna take every single piece out that door because we know it's perfect. Put every single piece in here, and we know that one is gonna be working like it's supposed to. And we're gonna rivet it back in because I got a rivet gun. We're gonna rivet it back in like it should be. And I already got the clips, new clips. We're gonna take the seal, the weather stripping right here, off of that one, put it on here, everything, man. And when that one is gonna be rolling up and down like it should, I'm telling you, little by little, man, you chip away at it. That'll be rolling up and down, door panels be on, interior. When the door panels get on, the interior start looking like something. It just, that right there is an eyesore. If it had little cracks in it and stuff, cool, but that don't got them huge cracks in it, it's an eyesore, man. But the good thing is, this piece is perfect. So I ain't gotta buy that, cause it's two separate pieces. That one, and then you got these, and the black piece right there. But them perfect. I just probably need the metal clips that snap onto the plastic so it snaps into place. Obviously I need them metal clips, which I know where to get them. So yeah, when I get that dash clip, the dash will be done. Cause I got the trim over there with the cigarette light and all. And I bought the AC control to take it, fill that gap, like I told you. Then I just buy me a radio, a head unit, and we're gonna have some music in here. We have some music in here before the month, out, believe me. So I checked Dolo still, slow rolling, dripping. The gas still dripping into the gas can. So other than that, I mean, I'm ready to roll now. I got everything done. For the day, I'ma go in here, I'ma open that up, that line up a little more so it'll drip faster. Take the guy carburetor apart so I can get it ready for a rebuild, cause I'm actually gonna try to have him done today. one-day turnaround. So I'm going to take him, put him in the tank, get it clean. Then my in-laws come back. I'll be ready for rebuild. I come out here tonight, dial him in, and he'll be ready for pickup one-day, same-day turnaround. And I'll be clear to go for the track. So when wifey get back, what we're going to do is actually, instead of me tearing in the deck, we're going to go ahead and go to A-Rod so I can get the nitrous. Because they're going to take time to get the nitrous for Dolo. And we're going to come back and see what we get into. Y'all see old wife out there? Hey, she been driving the mess out of R&B, boy. I'm glad, though. I told her, man, back the thing out here, man. You need to start driving. Cause she ain't want to bat. I don't know. It ain't gonna get. I said, nah, it ain't gonna get stuck. Not while the ground hard. And I know what y'all probably been wondering about this. Man, it's coming. I have paid for it. Truly, I paid for it early in the year. But my guy, concrete guy, man, he been going through it just with his machines and stuff. He good, but what I'm saying, his machine one, it's a bad look, man. Just one. He get it going, then the truck went down, then he got the other truck rolling, the other truck went down, and it just, man, you know, hey, when it rain, it pours sometime. I'm understanding I ain't tripping. So it's coming, he told me, hopefully within the next 2 weeks now, he back up and rolling, so I'm happy for that, I'm happy for him. But before, you know, you make do, you got to be patient with folk, man. So we got her car out, and we've been parking it out there. That's why R&B been parked out there, so she ain't got to keep backing in and out. She been driving, so. She been in it today, man. So everybody getting the thumbs up. So I'm happy for her. But I told her, hey, I got to get this ready, cause you clean, I got to be clean. I told wife, I ain't got nothing clean no more. Not just, you know, all the way clean. That need paint. Dolo need paint in, interior done. So I said, let me do this. Let me get this thing clean. So, and I ain't painted many of my rides. Y'all saw that, I painted brown coat. And people will be like, why you don't paint? Why you don't paint? Like, that's so simple. That's just too simple, man. I mean, they drop off and get your body parts and stuff. And I get that why I don't be stressing it. I like doing this stuff. I said, they're more tedious. But it is going to get painted. Y'all will see this car painted very soon. I can't wait for y'all to see the color. It's going to be clean. Y'all can see when I get down. When Jay paints something, he paint it. He get it done. He do it right. So it's going to be clean, man, especially the billet specialties. Woo! Wee. So, and I think I'm going to run billet specialty for my street rims. Like, instead of my Monte Carlo mask, I'm going to keep them. But I'm going to keep my front runners on at all time because I run a street tire on mine. And I'm going to buy another set of back wheels. Because I remember the first time I saw these wheels on the LF Monte Carlo, I was like, boy, that's it there. That is it. So, but yeah, let me give y'all one more look at that thing, but it ain't pretty. But y'all stay tuned, man. We ain't done. I'll turn y'all on in a few. All right, we're checking in, y'all. We're checking in. So, got to A-Rod. They had no nitrous, man. But, you know, it is what it is. I told it's all good, so I topped it up with him for a little bit and all of that. So, y'all look who it is, man. Y'all been asking about him. That Unk, man. Told me picking up carburetor. He got me on a task right here. What you said the thing was doing?
It coming out of there. Fuel coming out of there.
Oh, yeah.
There.
Oh, everywhere. It coming out of everywhere.
Boy, that's old dude leather carburetor right now.
Yeah, we got to get that. Hey, look. Look, this thing going to look so different when he get it back. Oh, we still got gas in it, don't
we? Yeah.
Hold on, I got to put that pan. I'm going to cut y'all off. I'm just letting y'all see Unk, man. Y'all be asking about him, so. I'm finna get this in the truck then. We're gonna get them straight, so y'all stay tuned. Okay, we back at the house from A-Rod. Oh, excuse me, and Unk. And said my in-laws back. They got me some more E. I told them they go to Summit sometime for me, do my Summit runs when I'm real busy. Getting a lot done, it'll be a huge help. So they I grabbed one more fuel jug, cause today was the last day they was on sale. So I grabbed one more fuel jug and we got 5 more gallons of E, pump E85. So that way I have enough fuel for 2 full tanks. If I remember right, I think I got enough tanks. Let me see. But now, I got to make some junk happen. Yeah, we got enough gas for 3 full tanks, cause I got 6. So see, when I fill these up, 30 gallons. So right now I got 40 gallons of E. So then I gotta put the tops on the rest. Now I got two more tops. I gotta put them together and all that. But yeah, man, good to go. Had to take advantage of that sale while they had it going on. But now the next task is switch right here on the grill. I did my grill. The next task is to go ahead and get this bottle bracket mounted. So I'll be done in the shop. Said I just got an extra set of brackets. All I need is this one. But that's your front right there. But we don't need the front. So it's a certain spacing you're supposed to do between these brackets. I think it's 15 and a half for the 15. 7.5 for the 7.5 for the 10 pound. If I remember right, I'm gonna look on the site though, Nitrous Express, just to be sure. But yeah, we got to get this done before it get dark. And I hope I got some bolts. I hope I got some bolts, man, in the bolt bin, cause I didn't buy none. So I hope I got enough to do what it do. This thing here ready though. Ooh. Man, them seats transformed that car, man. That just tripped me out. But it's been another busy day. The next 3 days gonna be busy. This been busy. Tomorrow gonna be busy. I got a carburetor I'm picking up to build. One I'm buying, of course. I'm buying as a core to build. And gotta do that in the morning. Then we gotta get Airtran loaded up for the track tomorrow. Then the day after that, we gotta get this one loaded up for the track. So, you know, busy day. So my thought is, hold on, let me see. Let's pull out the tape measure. I need to put y'all on the gimbal, man, so I can have my hands free. So hold on. 15 and a half, about right there. Let's lock it. So, dang, got some tape on it. What the hell right there? Tina got me this, man. Father's Day. I love the tape measure. Oh, Shell, always. No, Shell might have got me this. They all get me this stuff Father's Day. I love this stuff. But, so, 15 and a half. So, that bracket gonna be about back here. So, what we're gonna do, 15. Is make sure you clear too. Make sure you don't go into the pump. So we're gonna go right here with that bracket and make sure that baby in line. And then we come under here and make sure we clear too. Check your clearance. Make sure you ain't gonna be going into nothing, which I'm good to clear. As you can see, I think we right above. Here we go. I don't know if y'all can see it, kind of blurry, but we good and clear, man. We ain't going into the line and pump and all that right there. So I will check your clearance before you get to going crazy drilling holes and stuff. All right. So I'm gonna set y'all up on the gimbal and get this thing mounted, man.
Y'all gotta excuse the lawnmower, man. Father-in-law ain't going in. But I got it mocked up. This one right here won't be used, obviously, because this had a swell of the bracket. So this one be obsolete when I'm bolting the 15 pound in. So that right there pretty much non-existent, because it ain't gonna reach around the bolt or the bottom. But I could change. No, I can't. Excuse me. So, what we're gonna do is make a mark. I want to see if I can see this. And then we're gonna drill. I wanted to see. I don't know if we're gonna be able to see this right here. I doubt it. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to see that, cause he's dirty right there. So I need a marker for this. I should have been bought one, but I ain't got now. So you gotta make it do what it do. But it's all right, y'all. It's more than one way to skin a cat. Came out that glove, you just might see it. You just might. Get that bottle out the way. I just had it right there to keep that bracket from moving. Keep it stationary. Cause I can't get no nitrogen, man. I'm gonna have to do this. I came up with a plan B. But I had been telling wife I want to do this cause both of them use the same. This one, Dolo and Meats use the same size nitrous line. Day six, so I've been wanting to do this. Then I can make the most out of all bottles, at least with Dolo Meats. I won't be doing this. That's how it would move. Let's see. It took a wood move. And it didn't show up on things either. This I'm gonna wood move, y'all. Yeah, we're gonna have to use it on. We're gonna have to use the what's the name? Liquid thread sealant. We're gonna get it though, hold on. So what I'm doing now is just making this marking my spot so I know where to drill, and then it free my hands up. So I'm gonna set that right there, right at the bottom. One more time. I can really do it like this. Right there. Right there. Here's my key fob. We're gonna get this. See, you had that pen there, what I said, but you had the right tools. You have to be doing all this crazy stuff. Get the right stuff you need, man. But I usually use a mark and stuff like that. So. Need about right there. Use a straight edge. Keep the thing still. I'll wipe it off the bracket, y'all. I'm just trying to get it to go through on the body of the car. On the trunk. Got don't know this stuff. It wipe off.
Yeah, I just want to go through.
So one right there. Right there. Got it.
All right. Alright, so we got it all done, all locked in, locked and loaded. Just tried to fight a little bit, but we got it in there. So now we're ready for a 15 or 10 pound box. So we got that done, so this car should be ready to roll. Now I ain't got nothing to do, nothing else left to do. I drained all the gas and I just got like a probably about 2 gallons of race fuel in there. The rain percentage keep going up and down, and if it rains, I don't want to have a tank full of racing gas in this car like I done before many times, man. So you know, it's all good. So the last thing that I have to do today is in time. See, that's why I said time get to running up on you, man. Listen, that I'm gonna get the guy carbureted tow down no matter what, but I wanted to kind of get it built today too. I don't think they're gonna happen because I ain't running myself raggedy, running myself thin. But I have a small window of time before I leave for the track. So the objective tomorrow is to go pick up this other carburetor that I'm buying, that I will have for sale. I got to tear down the bill, but that's going to be next week. But the objective is tear it down tonight, go meet the guy in the morning, get that, come back, clean that one, and get it built and dialed in before I load up to go to the track. Then I go into the weekend, cool, everything. But either way, man, I get it done when I get back, because we ain't going to be at the track all night in air train. But like I said, I'm probably ain't gonna make no more than 2 passes, be real with you, cause ain't too much you can do with that car right now. So all in all, man, it's been a good day. We got the seats in, we got Dolo set up for a 15 pound bottle. My bad, y'all, got cut off. But like I said, we got the Dolo set up for a 15 pound nitrous bottle. We went to go get some nitro, but we didn't have none. But that's all right, because now, since this car is set up to take a 15 or a 10, we good. Because I got one full 15-pound bottle, and I got one full 10-pound bottle. But it doesn't have the lightning valve on it. So it's a regular valve 10-pound bottle, but I got two of these. And this not completely empty, but it might have one pass in it, so... But I like, if I'm going in, I like a fresh bottle, man. Fresh bottle, better safe than sorry. So, we should be good. So, Dolo ready to go, man. I should have to tinker with this car. This car going the day after. So, both are track ready now officially. I ain't got nothing else left to do. Well, I got to take my jacket and stuff out of this car. But other than that, that's it. So, that's the end of this vlog, man. So, appreciate y'all. I'm going to catch y'all later. BCG, we out.